their homes there. The Igbo people have built hotels and factories all over the world. They build hotels back to the southeast. Dangote will take his factories to the north. We just say things, we don't even ask ourselves questions. We don't even think through all these things. The southerners go to the north for God's sake, it's because they saw opportunities. The southeast, the people are becoming millionaires, doing business there. It's not simple, they want their just to please somebody. And even if you break up and you now have a problem of Southern Nigeria, a problem of Northern Nigeria, those Nigerians live in other countries. There are Nigerians in Benin Republic, there are Nigerians in Togo. So Northern Nigeria will just be another country. Southern Nigeria will just be another country. Without leave the conflict. So why don't we think of how we can find what binds us together in this adversity that we are facing, so that we can confront the leadership and begin to ask them questions, so that we can begin to put them on the spot. I've had experience where people come to me, they want to play some ethnic game, and they say, hey, can't you see this, can't you see that, can't you see that this part of the state, they are monopolizing the power, they don't want us to be governor. I say, look, Obasanjo appointed ministers from our area. Four of them are bonus times. What did they do for you? The road in my village was started in 1977. Nobody has done it. If I just now land at, it's a very long stretch of road. It's just now land at President Jonathan has awarded it. Since 1977, what roads everywhere? And we have produced senators, we have produced House of Reps, members, we have produced four ministers. And those ministers did one for themselves. That is the irony of it all. Everywhere I go, I've been doing a very simple research for the past 10 years. Any state I go to, from the airport, I'll be talking to the cabman. So what are your problems? Ah, there's no food though. Ah, my children, no hospital. None of them saying, my problem is the Igbo man. Who can say my children last time? I've seen ordinary Nigerians interact. They don't have a problem. It is time to whip up these sentiments for political gain and the elite. The political elite, they just mess us around. And that's why I'm imploring us, let us unite as young people with one goal, to challenge those who are in authority over us. I'm not saying we should fight them, but we should ask questions. We should begin to ask the hard questions. There are 170 million in Nigeria, according to all the statistics. You know, I have my reservations about that, but that's for another day. Now, even if it is 1,000 of us that decide that we start asking questions, it doesn't take 170 million people to change Nigeria. We should start asking questions. Today we are talking about how much is being spent on Aso Rock on food every year. What of your state government? Have you asked how much they spend on food? A House of Assembly recently, I won't mention the state, they went on a retreat to Ghana. We can retreat. 200 million naira. 200 million naira. Is this something national problems that will solve that kind of problem? Do you know how much our governments are spending on private jets, charter jets? In those days, we used to meet them when you are flying to Abuja, the announcer would say, "Your Excellency." I've not had, the last time I saw any governor on the plane was Governor Peter Obi. And that, I was flying to any good idea, and we met on the plane. That was the last time I saw him. In the last 4 years, I can't remember hearing the Excellency on the plane. Now, you have ministerial jets, because ministers also have their own arrangements. A lot of waste, a lot of corruption in the system. Me, I'm always thinking in terms of bubbles and portals, and when you say 200 million, I just imagine how many lives that could have saved. I wrote about a story recently in Zamfara State, the village is called Benin River. Every year, people were dying from cholera. And it's not rocket science. These people were drinking from the stream, and they were using pitch latrines. And then, long before, the water will flow, pack everything. And I said, wait, there are places in this country, the same river, that's where they are going to drink water, that's where they are going to wash. But there's a way they deceive themselves. If they wash here, they will not come there and take the water. Forget it that somebody has lost the water. Now, people were dying in this village cholera. Then somebody came. 200,000 naira sunk a borehole. That was the end of cholera death in that village forever and ever. 200,000 naira. It's not up to what they spent buying a bag for those tiny university girls that they are coming around. So we have irresponsible leadership. And what I'm saying, if you ask questions, is that it's a process. When people can no longer go home the way they used to go, they know that we know there's trouble. We need, for me, two C's. Competent, we're not even two C's. We're talking about competent and patriotic, two-faced leaders. Competent because we have leaders who are not competent. We have leaders who don't even understand the concept of development. They don't even understand what they are doing. They just, there was one, I was told a story of one person that did a coup. And in the name of Swami, he appointed the secretary of government. He was about to read his inaugural speech. He now told the secretary of government that, please, what should we tell Nigerians that we want to do? We did a coup, we didn't even have a plan. So what should we tell Nigerians? That secretary of government became so powerful. Perhaps the most powerful secretary of government ever had this country. Because the other thing he said was something else. So when you're ever going for a public position, you don't know what you want to do. You don't know where you are going. You don't know. And it's not as if we don't have competent people in this country. So competence is one point. Because you can have people who are competent, we are not patriotic. You see a lot of competent people going to government. Oh my God, by the time they come out, you will recognize them again. It's the patriotism that will drive you. That no, things cannot be like that. But we also have some leaders that are patriotic, but not in there. So that's how we need the two. You must be competent. You understand what you are talking about. And you must be patriotic. And this is what I think should drive us. I'm very happy with the advent of the social media. Because we are able to reach out to these people. There was a school where there were no chairs, no nothing. Pupils were sitting or standing or stooping. They were sitting on the floor again or stooping or standing to receive lectures. And then we say, we are all create failures. Hi. How can you stand to receive lecture and anything you enter like? People don't have access to water. People walk up early, school and walk up very early to go to the stream to fetch water. Buckets on their head. Go 3 times. When you now go to school and they'll be teaching you chemistry. What will you do? You have schools where people are learning chemistry without chemicals. So we have to begin, start from the local government. We focus too much on Abuja. We should still hold Abuja responsible. But most of that can complain of Nigeria as long as Abuja we are talking about. But from your local government. I went to bury my grandfather in November. I came back from the village and I was in tears. One of the counselors told me they got more than 25 million or so allocation in 1 month, and that only 5 million entered the account of the council. That all the godfathers, everybody took their own. This one took. So he said, by the time the 5 million came, it was not enough to do anything. They took their own. So the money was not enough. And so we have primary schools, secondary schools down, autos, drainage, everything down. And then we'll just be talking about Abuja. There's a place for us to blame Abuja. There's also a place to hold our council chairman and chairwoman and our governors responsible. And stop looking for excuses. You hide under too many excuses. To round up, I will just repeat what I've said. We have to hold our leaders responsible. We should stop taking sides where they are fighting. We should stop supporting old PDP or new PDP. It's the same set of people. We must ask questions. I will continue to repeat that. Ask questions. Ask questions. So that through that we can, as one people, put these people on their feet To be fair, some governors are doing well, relatively. You know, when the students call